Hey, this is LT, and you're listening to CigarChatRadio.com, CCR. That's right. Welcome back to the lounge here at CigarChatRadio.com, Studio D104. And it's another segment of The Perfect Match. It's perfect just having you guys tune in to the lounge here at CigarChatRadio.com. And, man, we're going to find out what's your perfect accompaniment. Hey, maybe it's a trip up to Lake Tahoe to Cliché, the fabulous cigar bar inside Harrah's Casino. Yes, we may be taking a trip up that way to bring you another cigar-friendly location around the globe. In the meantime, we're going to warm you up the way we do with some cool sounds right here at CCR.
You had plenty money back in 22. You let all the women make a fool of you. Why don't you do right like some other men do? Get out of here and get me some money too. You're sitting down wondering what it's all about. You ain't got no money, they will put you out. Why don't you do right like some other men do? Get out of here and get me some money too. If you had repaired 20 years ago, you wouldn't be wandering off from door to door. Why don't you do right like some other men do? Get out of here and get me some money too.
Ah, yes. Now why don't you guys just straighten up and do right? That's right. Tune in to CCR CigarChatRadio.com. Hey, you guys are doing right. You're doing just fine by me, listening right here at Cigar Chat Radio, live in Studio D104 for another segment of The Perfect Match. And you will do yourself right by enjoying this perfect match. In fact, I have a special song for you guys. Now, I know I have a lot of female listeners to Cigar Chat Radio because not only men smoke cigars, but I have a special tribute to you guys that I want to share before we delve into this segment of the Perfect Match, which actually is going to just give you guys a nice little bit of a clue as to what the match is for this week, But more important than that, I just want to inspire you guys. I want to be a leader and lift my fellow cigar aficionado brothers up. So we've got a special treat for you. Setting the tone, man. I'm sitting. Look, you guys are kicked back by now. The stogies are lit. You know, I'm just setting the tone a little bit. I'm just getting you guys ready. Now, this is about the perfect match, right? So I have one more bit of inspiration, because I just want to make sure, perfectly sure, is my responsibility as the host of Studio D104 to to make sure that I set the tone right. So I have one more bit of inspiration, and then we're gonna take it home.
For the strong obey when the strong man shows them the way. Give me some men who are stout-hearted men who will fight for the right they adore. Start me with 10 who are stout-hearted men, and I'll soon give you 10,000 more. Oh, shoulder to shoulder, and bolder they grow as they go to the fore. Then there's nothing in the world can hold or mar a plan. When stout-hearted men can stick together, man to man.
Yeah. All right. Whew. You men feeling it yet? Stout-hearted men. Hey, you know what? It's all about porters. This week, the perfect match from Alderus. Alderus Porterus, so says the bottle. If you speak Latvian, of course, Porterus. But for the rest of us, porter. Stout. You know, back in the days, late 1700s, right? You had these river porters and road porters that would do the work, I guess, equivalent to a beast of burden. Okay, so you and pretend like it's a Friday night. You and half a dozen of your buddies decide, hey, let's go camping. Take some brewskis, take some sticks. Let's go out into the wilderness. Let's rough it a little bit. Okay, so you you guys all pile in the Range Rover. you pile in a Range Rover, head down to the river. You sort of get to the narrow point in the river, and you guys decide, that river looks a little deep for the range. Hey, let's grab those porters, and we'll just have those guys carry us across. I mean, because that's basically... I mean, that's basically what these guys did, right? You show up at the river. You don't want to get dirty. You aren't going to mess up the nice shoes, the slacks. Get the Rolex wet. I don't know. You might get the Rolex wet. That'll make you guys feel kind of rugged. Yeah. But so you hire these porters. So you and say half a dozen of your buddies hop up on some logs that they have thrown across their shoulders, and they basically wading chest deep in water, and they just kind of carry you guys across to the other side. So pray tell, the cufflinks would get soiled. Now wait a minute. Now I know there can't be that much of a disconnect. Now guys, you have to feel it. You know how Clint used to say, I feel you guys' pain. Now wouldn't you think that those guys deserve a nice stout brewski after a long day's work? Stout. No wonder they called it stout. You know, I could see someone with this big beer mug with just a frothy head of foam on it, and they're taking a big swig after a long day of hauling guys across the river Wadi. And another buddy comes up and just wham and just slaps him right in the back. You know, it's not to say, hey, good job, well done. It's to try to straighten you back up from the burden of the day's work. Come on, stand up straight. Be stout. Men. Give me some men who are stout-hearted men. Oh, my gosh. What, 6.6% alcohol, even back in the late 1700s, early 1800s, that's with Porter's beer. But, you know, that's kind of how it got its name, Porter. In fact, you know, modern day, you're on your way down to Cabo San Lucas. No, let's change that. You're headed up to Tahoe to spend the weekend at Cliché, which is their incredible cocktail lounge and cigar bar at Lake Tahoe. Over 50 brands of cigars, by the way. Davidoff, Opus X, Vintage Macanudos, to name a few. But, you know, you're heading out for the little weekend getaway. So you're at the airport. And what do you do? Hey, let's grab the Porter. let those guys do all of the work. Hey, you know what? A tribute to the Porters, the hardworking men and women around the globe that do a lot of work, carry the burdens for a lot of us in a lot of ways. But fantastic product, Alderus, Porterus, 2007. What, silver medal at the International Beer Award in Australia, and I think 2009 European Star Award for brewing beer. This particular product, right? You know, needless to say, these guys have been making, Latvians have been making beer for a while. So, you know, it's only normal to, with that much practice, to, I guess, do it well. But I have to tell you, this is a great, great surprise for me. And, you know, we're always learning, growing. Everyone has different tastes. Mine happens to be port, but not porterous, port wine. You know, some people like champagne, some cognac, but, you know, we all drink kind of a little bit of everything, I guess. But no one likes everything, present company included. So I have to say, willing to try mostly anything once, but I've just not been a big beer drinker, so it's kind of fun to for me to learn something new as well. And a lot of complexities in brewing beer, and no wonder it's a great companion hobby to companion industry to winemaking and the manufacturing of cigars, because there's an art to it, and it's amazing, the art and the blends, and what is it that gives the beers their particular flavors and nuances. The same with cigars, the same with fine wine. And you know, this one, no exception. Porter, made from dark malts, what gives it its color. And of course, you've got the double porter, extra porter, stout, and